Hello friends, now we are going to find out area of the triangle for different types. So we have three different types of triangles. This is right angle triangle. As you correctly guessed, one of the angle is 90 degree. We have acute angle triangle, wherein all the angles are less than 90 degree, and we have obtuse angle triangle, wherein one of the angle is more than 90 degree. Let's find out area of these triangles. We have a cutout of right angle triangle with base as this side and height as this side. Now let me divide this height into exact half by folding. See, like this. Let me cut it. Now try to fit it so that it can become a rectangle. Just see. Ta-da! So this right angle triangle, when it is cut into half of its height, it actually becomes a rectangle with base and height as its two sides. Isn't it amazing? So we have found here also that area of this right angle triangle is half, as we have taken the height as half, base times height of the rectangle. Now we have an acute angle triangle with us, wherein all the angles are less than 90 degree. Can we do the same thing as we did in the right angle triangle? Let me think. If I cut this into half, it may not fix here. What should I do? Let me try. So this I will consider as base and its height. H. If I divide this height into exact half, okay, nice. So now I'm cutting this and let me try what I okay. So two parts I have got, but it is not fixing. This is something else. Oh, I'm getting a parallelogram, but I'm not getting a rectangle. What should I do? Let me cut this smaller triangle into exact two triangles, smaller triangles. Let's see if it fits. See, it is fitting exactly, and what we have got from the same acute angle triangle, we have got now a rectangle, and this rectangle has the base of the triangle and its height as the half of the height of the triangle. Hence we can prove that area of this triangle, acute angle triangle, is half base times height. Okay, now what will happen if we have an obtuse angle triangle? So in the obtuse angle triangle, if we consider the base to be the longest side, we can do the similar way what we did in acute angle triangle. Suppose it is not so, and the base, as I have written here, is one of the small sides. So I have written here B as a base and height. Let me show with this. This is the total height of this point till here, is the total height of the triangle. Now if I want to make this height as half, so I will get a point around this. Let me draw a line which is parallel to the base. See, so we have got exact half of the height. Let me denote it with H. So this height H is half of the height of the obtuse angle triangle. Let me cut it. Okay, so we have got a figure, and wherein I can join this part, but something is missing. See, so we got a sort of parallelogram. What should I do next? Let me cut this point. So this parallelogram has now become the rectangle, see? And this rectangle has H as its height and base as a B. So we have proved that again in obtuse angle triangle the same works, that is area of the obtuse angle triangle is also half into base into height. So in this way we have proved in all the three cases that area of the triangle is given by the formula half base into height, which is correct. So friends, we have seen that area of the triangle is half base times height. You don't have to remember or memorize the formula. You have found yourself in all the three cases, it is true. So if you like this video, please watch our other videos also in the YouTube channel IISER Pune Science Activity Center. Thank you so much.